Long ago, there existed a god. Then evil came.
What's good, YouTube Underworld 6667? I know I missed you too, guys. Thank you for the condolences for those who thought I was dead, but I wasn't. I'm here today because one of my newest subscribers actually reached out to me on Facebook after she watched the Yu-Gi-Oh! 101 series that's on the channel right now and had further questions about how to become a better vendor. As you guys know, I've been focusing on my company, Underworld Shop and Design, where we sell custom playmats, both embroidered edge as well as standard, on underworldsd.com. Yes, random plug. She had asked me about things, where to get cards, how to get better suppliers, how to get better vendors, how to make more money. And we actually broached the topic on Monster Reborn and how to predict Monster Reborn was coming off the ban list. Now, for some of you, I'm sure it was obvious that Monster Reborn was coming off the ban list, but for those who don't know, Monster Reborn was going to be reprinted because Konami had this brilliant idea that people wanted the OCG artwork on TCG cards. Now, based on the rules and regulations of North America, they weren't able to actually print some of the artistic work on the cards here in the TCG, such as religious symbols or big old titties. Now, Konami was able to sneak through that Monster Reborn with the Ankh on it, which can be seen in the OCG. Now, how does Konami sell a banned card that only has a little bit of nostalgia with their little tiny change in the artwork when the card is not playable because it is banned? That's right. We'll unban it, sell a whole bunch of product, then re-ban it. Unless it's a garbage card and it actually doesn't affect the TCG at all. Well, we're Konami. We only count money. We don't actually look at the game and actually try and help things. I mean, what? We definitely do. We have no rules and restrictions on ban lists anymore. We give them a time limit. So on the time limit day, the very next day, we could always re-ban it if it's ruining things. Well, that's gonna just make us a ton of money, and I think that's just what we're gonna do. It's pretty obvious that Konami really, really gives a crap about money more so than the actual playability of the game, mainly because if they see a deck and it's doing very well, what you'll think is they're banning it because it's too broken. What Konami actually does is they ban it so you have to purchase the newer product that is just as equally amazing as the old product. If you want to play in tournaments, if you want to be amazing, you have to buy the new product. Konami is smart, guys. Be smart like Konami, think like Konami, and you'll be able to actually make a ton of money in this game. You have the ability, you have the resources, people are talking about it constantly. I'm gonna give you guys a big ol' hint. They're coming out with new hero support. That's it. That's the big hint. They're coming out with new hero support. Hopefully you guys like this video. If you want more content, press that little like button. If you want more content frequently, share it on Zodiac Duelist, share it with other YugiTubers, and let them know that Underworld 6667 is back, and he's pissed. Who's on the fucking day?